Yes.
That day I first saw you passing by, I wanted to know your name, but I was much too shy. But I was looking at you so hard until your mustache had a smile. So you came up to me and asked me, what's your name? And beat me to the punch. That time you beat me to the punch. Oh, 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 oh. You beat me to the punch. Oh, after I hadn't known you for, it seems like a long, long time. I wanted to ask you, would you be?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Call up your friends and call up your neighbors. Let them know the show is on. The Men That Speak About Herbs. But before I go any further, I will be exercising my right of the First Amendment of the Constitution of the United States of America. And bear that in mind that you also have that right. I speak about herbs and their medicinal purpose. As you can see here that I have many variety of herbs, and they're good for all type of problem of the body, such as cold of the intestine, cold of the gut, chest pain, arthritis, tuberculosis. There are many different type of herbs that can get the human body well. But guess what? The black men of the Western world are not using herbs. Why they are not using herbs? Because they have been taught by the white men not to use herbs, because herbs are dangerous to use. Such as marijuana. As you can see, I have some small little plant of marijuana here. And I speak in past program about marijuana. If you have the basic knowledge on how to use herbs, you will know that you should not smoke these herbs. This herb was found on the grave of Solomon. And Solomon was the wisest black man ever exist in past time. But you see, the white men changed things around. Our history that we have, they changed the history to their way. And every icon of the Bible, they are white people. Up to their Jesus, as you call him Jesus, they are white people. And also the God is white. Because if the Son is white, then the Father have to be white. Huh? Isn't it? Of course. A black man cannot have a Chinese baby. Now, if the Son is white, the Father have to be white. Now, as I said, I speak about the Bible a little, because the Bible are so symbolic that the black men of the Western world just base their mind upon the book you call the Bible. You see? And what's happened? They lost their sense of direction, because they don't remember that the Bible, the original language, was made by the black men, and the white men translate all the original language into their language. There was no English language. What did you say? I said there was no English language. Huh. Oh, you didn't know there was no English language? I am telling you that the book that you call a Bible, there was no English language. This was written in Amharic. Come on, black man. Translate into Hebrew, to Latin, to Greek. Then the white men make the language English. So they take words from different languages. So how could the black man caught up in such book? Something got to be wrong. Something got to be wrong, black man. How comes you caught up in the book so much? You just lost your sense of direction. We don't know how to plant grains anymore for our children to have food abundantly. What do you think going to happen? We're not going to have a strong nation because the white man already work you out. He work you from sunup until sundown. And most of our people die. Do you know how many black people die in the Western world from working from the hands of the enemies? They work them. The Indian was the first people who worked, they were black people. Then the white men work us until we die. Because they see that we could work hard. So the more we work is the more they work us. And they give you freedom. And you see, they didn't give you any justice. If black people didn't have justice, then we would have power. So we didn't get any justice, so we have no power. So guess what? We just beg the white men for everything. Then we call them blue-eyed devils. They are not blue-eyed devils. They are clever people that take care of their own. Huh. Did you hear me, black man? They take care of their own people. And we depend upon them for them to take care of us. We got to be a sick race. Because they gave you a white man they call Jesus, and you must bow down to that man and worship the white people. So when you worship the white people, they got to subdue you. Because we have not the basic knowledge that they are our enemies. Because we forget that they are our enemies. Not just in the Western world. They moved on into Africa many years ago and slaved our people. Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon. He slaved black people. Your own black people say slave black people. Pharaoh was a black king. He slaved the black people. But guess what? If your people slave your people, it's not too bad. But if another race slave another race of people, that is bad. They become your enemies. So what you have to do is get rid of the enemies. How do you get rid of enemies? You must either use herbs or magical spells. Most black men in the Western world, they use guns to get rid of their enemies or poison. You can use herbs to get rid of your enemies. And we are not teaching the children how to use herbs. All the children are going unconcerned. The fathers are not in the home. The mothers are not in the home. So the children let loose. The mother cannot guide the children. She's just a comforter. The father's got to be there to guide the children and put down authority. They're not at home. You know where they are? They're running the street, unconcerned, afraid to take care of the children. Putting all your responsibility on the government. You could get all type of benefit from the government and still be home to take care of the children and guide them and teach them your way. You cannot leave it to the white man. That's the enemies. He's not going to teach the children anything. That's why all the black men end up in prison. Why? Why are they in prison? Over some narcotics? Over some car stealing? They fix it that way. When the boys reach maturity, they must go to prison and end up as a criminal. And the preachers, all the preachers do, base their mind on this book and confuse the black children. And the mothers and the fathers going there singing hallelujah, praising the Lord, praising a white man. You could imagine that? A white man they are praising. And forget that the white man is the enemy. Did you see what all these black people are doing? Going to a place you call church and they are praying to a white man. A white man. This is the man they're praying to, a white man. You gotta be sick. And we are the people that suffer more than any race upon the face of the earth. We have no gold, no diamond, no language, no land. The white men devour all of that, and they take care of their own. Black people, you better wake up. As I said, I'm here to teach you about herbs and magical spells. And if you have any problem with demons and your physical body are sick, high blood pressure, disease, sores of the rectum, the penis, the vagina, I'm here. Call me. Don't be afraid to call me. Go to my... If you got problem, don't depend on the white men and depend on this book you have here that have been translated for so many times. The writing was on the skin of animals before the black men came to the Western world. And the white men changed everything and messed it up. So you don't know about herbs anymore. Where's the book of herbs? Where's the book of the beasts? Where's the book of the dead? They have a few little portions in there that they will take. Look, Ecclesiastes chapter 3. Take the... Oh, black people got to wake up. You have to wake up because they confuse everything. They take a little and they put there. So when you read it, if you read from Matthew to the Apocalypse, it is the same story over and over. Peter talk about James and James talk about John. Talk about Mary. Talk about a man you call Jesus. And that's what the preacher do. They read from Matthew to Apocalypse. And they go over it. They take one chapter, one verse into Genesis. And they go into Matthew. They take a chapter into Luke. And they put them together. They're not reading the story all the way down because it's repeat itself. And that's why the preacher have the members going and coming so you can give them donation. I don't need your donation. I'm here to tell your black people, wake up and see if we can take the land and plant grains so we can have food for our children and build a strong nation again. Instead of you going to some place to call church, you know what I think they should do? Turn them into schools. Sewing school, cooking school, farming school. And if you want to do church on Sundays, that's good. But they just have them sitting there wasting time. And our children is going to the white man's school, getting white man education, and comes and tell me you are educated. What type of education do you have? You go to a white school. You speak the white man language. Huh? You educated? Keep on thinking you're educated. You are just wasting your time. You're educated to survive in their world, but not in your world. And that's why you need to wake up, black man. And if you don't wake up, you're going to be messed up. Because all we do, we just leave up our children unconcerned. They're wearing their clothes filthy, baggy. Wrong sex going with the wrong sex. Have you seen all these young girls that are filthy and young boys? And the mother is doing nothing. The mother can't guide them. The father's not there. He's out there looking for something else. He's trying to get high. He want to feel good. See so what I'm saying? And when he come home, he beat his woman up. The woman is no good. So he can beat her up, go on the street and pick up a whole prostitute to do his filthy stuff. Then he beat his nice woman at home up. Come on, black man, I'm here to tell you, and the preachers need to cut out their foolishness and teach you the true knowledge of the black man. He's supposed to anoint your head with oil and pray for you. And look how many sick people are going to the church. And they're not getting better. Sick, 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 sick. Every Sunday these people are so sick. And they're not better. And the preacher will drive down the street in his fancy Mercedes Benz and will not even wave to you as a member. You are not good enough to drive in his car. Huh? But on Sunday you will go and give him present. Gold watch, gold chain. Envelope with a lot of large sum of money. You go and you buy big homes and put the money in the bank and go on vacation. Gotta be sick. I got a footage I'd like you to look at, because black men are getting so filthy that we lost our sense of direction. When are we going to wake up? When are we going to wake up? I'm here to rewash the black man's brains again. Yes, I want to rewash your brains. So you better wake up. Look at this footage that I have here. All these people are white people. And the black man is going there to worship these people. They're all white people. Could you imagine that? All white people. Look at that. Jesus, as you call him Jesus, when he was born. See? When he was born. Virgin with child. Luke chapter 1. That's what I'm telling you about. Black people, that's who they're worshiping, white people. And they said that man is the savior of the herd. They killed the man many years ago. It was a black man. And he could not save himself. Yes. Ordination of the baby. Luke chapter 2. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about, black people. Excuse me. Family flee to Egypt. See the baby? White people. Presentation in the temple. Luke chapter 2. See? White baby again. White men, white women. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. And all these... Look. Talking to lawyers and doctors. Luke chapter 2. See? White men again. See, that's how the people get confused. These are icons from the Bible, and all these people are white people. All these people are white people. I don't understand that. And all these people are worshiping all those men. Black people are doing it. Yes. He appeared to his disciple. See, he appeared to his disciple. Look at that. White man, white woman. Huh? How can the black people sit back and believe in such thing? Now we're sending into heaven. Transfiguration. Mark chapter 9. Huh? White people. So the black people are going to live with white people in heaven. Because Jesus is a white man. So his father got to be white. Because they said he's the son of God. G-O-D. Huh? Come on, black people. Peter denied him. Luke chapter 22. Huh? Look at that. They're all white people. Peter repented. Luke chapter 22. Still. Huh? And the black people believe all of that is true. They believe the story is right. Look at all those little children going into Jerusalem. Jesus triumphed in Jerusalem. You call him Jesus. A white man. The word Jesus, where does that originate from? Come on, preacher. The Virgin Mary. Matthew chapter 3. This is what I like. The Last Supper. This is so funny. This is so funny, black people. The Last Supper. They're all white people. Huh? All their icon is white people. But what is so funny? What is so funny? Look at it. Judas. Judas is the black man there. Judas is the black man. That's what I'm talking about. Judas is a black man. That what is so funny? Huh? And the people believe all of that story. So the black man is the devil. He's a Judas. He's a betrayer. He's no good. Huh? That's what they're telling you. So all of those people are white people. And the only person there is Judas. He's a black man. See that? They make that icon definitely for the black people. Huh? Is it real? Or is it just fantasy? Which one is it? Black people, is it real? That's what you want to believe? It's a shame if you continue to believe that. You know why? Because you're just wasting your time. And all your time will be wasted. Because you're waiting for a white man to come to save you and take you to heaven. And he's the abuser. He's abused my people. If you don't believe they abuse your people, that's your problem. As I said, I speak about magical spells, herbs and root. If you have any problem, write me a letter. Don't be afraid to write me a letter. I'm going to show you a magical spell. I have a animal here. You call it frog that Moses called up. You see, most of these stories are correct. Because they did not have words to change all of the story that the black man been written many times before the white man going to Africa. And the whole magician. All the men of the Bible are magician. But they put it in a way to fool your mind. Pharaoh, Moses, Goliath, David, the whole magician. Let me show you one thing that I have here. I have a frog here. Maybe you can't see too good. It's in a cage. So I put it in a cage that it don't get away. Because they like to get away a lot. So as I said, Moses used the frogs. And the frog is an animal that have medicinal purpose with it in itself. And it's a magical animal. You can do wonders with this animal if you know what to do with it. So I'm going to show you a magical spell that been done by the older man in time gone. See? He's trying to stand up as a man here. And I'm having problem putting on the string and the feet because I'm kind of running out of time too. But I hope I can show you this spell before my time expired. If you don't see it in this program, you'll see it in another program. Here's the frog. Now, I'm going to tie the frog up upside down. He's trying to get away here now. But he's not going to get away from me because I'm the one that tying him up. I'm subduing him. It's a boy too, see? So I said him. The ladies is outside in the cage. So see what I'm doing? I'm subduing this frog. I'm tying it up. It has so much medicinal purpose. I'm going to give you one spell from this frog right now. You see, in the book you call the Bible, Moses take the dust of the earth and sprinkle it, and there was frogs, like many, many frogs going to Pharaoh's house. As you know that Moses grew up in Pharaoh's house. Now, if you take this frog and you put tie it upside down and put a green dish underneath, see? It will drop white substance out of his mouth like milk. But you must tie it up that he cannot see you because it will be in terror and it will not die. And when the white substance comes out, you must save it and it will dry up from the moist. It will dry itself. And you know people that have epilepsy, or you call it fit? If you gave that to the person that have fit, they will not have fit anymore. The fit will go away from the body. Never have fit anymore. And that is one of the spells that I'm going to give you from the frog. And I have 1,000 spells from the frog. Because he has so much medicinal purpose. And he's an animal. And the government themselves use these animals for medicine. and they had chemical to the medicine. You know, you eat the legs of the frog, and the frog is a poisonous animal. Huh? It's a poisonous animal, and you eat the legs. Every 6 months, this frog disappear into the herd, and it put a veil over her face like a virgin girl. You know a virgin girl? She have a veil. Huh? Do you know where she have the veil? Not on her face. That's why she's a virgin. Huh? She got a veil. And if you break that veil before time, the government will lock you up, or the parents will lock you up. Because she's a virgin, and you should not break. Huh? Well, let me tell you something. I'm getting out of time. So write me a letter. Be good, as I said before. If you got some problem with your physical body, sores of the intestine, sores of the rectum, sores of the penis, sores of the vagina, write me a letter. Because there's a lot of people out there walking around stinky. And they are afraid. So as I said, be good. Be good. Be good to yourself. And keep on watching this program. You will learn some things. You will learn something. So don't.
So you came up to me and asked me, what's your name? And beat me to the punch.